Introducing New Age Sandwich Slices. It sure tastes like cheese.
With a lot less cholesterol.
Oh, and welcome to the LARPBook podcast. This is episode 48 for the 13th of December 2016. This is going to be our Christmas slash New Year slash whatever for 2016 show. So for that, and because he's such an awesome guy, we've actually got Lucas Epitomus Aurelius. I can't believe he's with us. Maximus Epitomus.
All right. What an intro. Hey, baby. Well,
you know.
How you doing?
And of course, with us as usual is Rob down there at the bottom. Where he should be, especially with his video tonight that makes him look like he's back in the 1980s. Well, let's be honest.
Where it should be.
Let's be honest.
Bruce technology, that's where you are right now.
Yeah, I mean, and let's be honest as well, the hair is from the 1980s anyway, so...
You know. Well, there's nothing wrong with that mullet. You keep it as long as you can.
So anyway, in tonight's show... 2016, a review, because it's almost the end.
What
2016 by J.R.R. Martin. Total Awesome Viking Power, LARP in 2016, Claus and the Arabian Tales. So let's get on with the show. Let's get rid of that music. Right, so hi Luke. It's good to have you back, man.
Hey, baby, you okay?
You know, it's
thanks for having me.
You know, it is good to see you. To see you,
yes.
Nice.
Yeah, thank you.
You know,
I've been hiding.
You have been hiding. Well, I know you've been super busy as well, so we'll let you off on that.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, isn't it just? You know, so I've been planning and plotting on my. You'll love this, by the way. I applied for my master's at Cardiff.
Okay.
And only this could happen to me, right? So this is how my year has gone. They rejected me because I applied too late. And then I got a pre-rejection for 2017-18 for a course I never even applied for. It was almost like, look, fatty, stop applying, okay? And I had to go in there and actually go into there and go, please stop actually pre-rejecting me for courses I haven't actually kind of applied for. It really hit my ego.
Just want to do one.
just let me do something, all right? Let me do something. So I've been very, very busy to sleep with half of kind of staff.
Fair enough.
For next year. You know. But there we go. So yes, so my year's been very, very, very hectic.
Well, you know, it's good. I mean, it's better to have a hectic year than a really boring one.
Yeah. Oh, I never get dull. You know me. We don't do dull.
No, exactly. Yeah. dull, and well, let's be honest. Our group of friends, dull doesn't exist, does it?
We don't know that word. It's not in our vocab.
No,
that doesn't happen.
It's not only in the vocab. I actually have no idea what it means, apart from the fact I need to buff the metal. Apart from that,
yeah.
Buff the metal. Am I missing something?
Yeah.
Well, it's a bit dull.
Why are we buffing metals, Hugh? What's the metal?
Because it's a bit dull. Okay.
Get off.
I really need to get on my soundboard a ch-ch-chum.
Yeah.
Or a tumbleweed.
You need that.
Or a tumbleweed sound, something like that. I don't know, either one. Does a tumbleweed make a sound?
Kind of rumbly, wishy. Don't forget, instantrimshot.com.
Instant rimshot. See, when you say rimshot like that, it always sounds a bit dirty. Anyway.
Yeah.
So let's start off with a little bit of news, and the news that we've got is good. It could be better, but we picked up 260 Facebook followers since January, so that's great. Thank you all very much. That is superb. Yeah, so we just need more followers now. So tell your friends, tell your enemies, Tell your frenemies. Whatever works for you. Yeah. Let people know about us. Get them to the Facebook page. That's where everything pretty much happens. And of course, over to larpbook.com. So with that, on that thing, with the right, we will put this link up because it is a video, but everybody needs to go and see this.
Oh, and Luke, yeah.
And Luke, if you have not seen this, you so need to see this. It is total awesome Viking power.
And okay. I like it already.
As a fan film, oh, as a channel, you can subscribe. There's going to be more.
There's going to be more. So anyway.
It's called Total Viking Power.
Total Awesome Viking Power. Total Awesome Viking Power.
I'm just writing this.
Okay. So anyway, Vikings and Pirates has released its first short film, Total Awesome Viking Power, on YouTube, directed by Morten Forland. It's about a Viking LARPer who's sentenced by his crew to the land of the dead for breaking the cell phone code of conduct. There, he comes across the Norse god Odin, who may or may not be the real deal. Who teaches him the ways of the Viking so he can fight. You guessed it, magical ninjas.
Oh.
There's everything you could possibly need.
There's Odin again.
You know, there is possibly everything you could possibly need in that sentence. And yes, by the way, that sound in the background was the real Odin in real life. Woof, woof, woof.
He's barking at a blade of grass or something moving.
So
never going to be that lucky.
That's right. Yeah. So
it's not going to be a magical ninja then.
What?
If they're magical ninjas, I'd be very upset if the dog found them.
Exactly.
Yeah. World's worst magical ninjas.
Yeah. So.
But it is worse.
Narcoleptic.
Narcoleptic ninjas. I want those guys.
We still should have done those. We should have done that. And you and I both know that we should have done that. But, you know, unfortunately, the planets did not align and all the rest of it. So,
no.
You know, but there's an idea still for anybody that wants to do a little bit of comedy in a LARP. Narcoleptic ninjas, okay, or assassins, whichever one we want to go for. So basically every time they almost get to stab their... Yeah, and they just fall asleep.
But fortunately, they work in a team, so the next one picks up the baton. I mean, deadly stabby thing. And baton. Goes forward. Well, okay, deadly stabby thing. It sounds better than the baton. And this is very about to get there.
Yeah, exactly. So, Yeah, we never ever did that, and we really should have done. So anyway, I'm going to move on to the talking points because we've got so much to get through tonight. It's ridiculous, yeah. And thank you very much, Luke, for this. It's absolutely superb because we love you, man. Right. So has LARP taken a turn for the positive in 2016? Now I'm going to kind of kick this off a little bit. Yeah, Rob has written a couple of notes. Yeah, will we see more blockbuster LARPs, and what is blockbuster LARP, and the rise of production quality in LARPs? What we have seen, what we have experienced, over this last year, it seems to be that the quality of LARPs, the amount of LARPs, and the acceptance, in my mind anyway, in my opinion, has shot up through the roof. Yeah, gone are the little, what, less class mom and pop, you know, games, and the level of quality even in the smaller games has just gone, you know, through the roof. Discuss. Luke,
wake up, Luke. We lost Luke.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
No. Yeah. You can hear me now though, right?
I can hear you now.
So yeah, what I did without trying to kill everyone's ears, and then I pressed the mute button and then it just... I've got to do it. I think you're right. I think things like Comic Cons have, because they've brought a lot of people to the concept of, you know, cosplay, and there's a direct link to that. You've then got your live action, your cosplayers, you've got your, you know, your reenactors, and underlying link, which And, you know, whether they like it or not, I think it's become more popular. People have got more choice, so they're willing to give it a go. You know, all the films normalize it as well. So I think it was a real rise in the profile of it. It's good to be geek.
Yeah.
And it's an enormous step forward, you know?
Yeah, no, I agree. I think the rise is good to be geek. The rise of sort of geekdom as an accepted good thing is making an enormous difference.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, if you remember what Claus said as great unwritten, we're signing on to, you know, our very conservative kind of society was really unhappy with the concept of, you know, cosplay and a live action role play. You know, when you guys went over to Sin, this huge world of a difference. And, you know, we're only a matter of, I reckon, about 5-10 years down they are now. It's more open, and who knows, you know, this could form part of a curriculum.
I think we're actually closer than that. Putting, like, for example, putting LARP into schools, I happen to know a couple of people who are working on this right now. I was chatting online this weekend to Ollie McSee, who run Legends Quest, and they had a really successful weekend in Ride, putting their show on.
Okay.
They're getting a now for the next week. They're pretty much sold out. And one of the things they're planning for next year now is to bring a LARPing education experience directly into schools.
Okay.
So yeah.
An independent company trying to bring LARPing as an education medium into schools in this country. I also know people like Gideon. So he's now gone professional on things like storytelling, living history, and bringing things forward. And he's also working with the educational sector to move that forward as well.
Oh, excellent! And that's in the UK.
That's in the UK. That's in the West Country. Right. And we had some at TR. We had some contact with the Wilderness Centre a couple of months ago.
Yeah,
and they're looking at doing educational and team building labs for kids coming up into 2017.
Oh, okay.
So the things are beginning to roll in this. So I don't think we're we're behind pieces like Denmark, but I don't think we're 5 or 10 years behind.
All right.
Well, I mean, I people would open the border stuff. So I suppose the biggest problem for me is I think that society generally is missing out on a really good thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Embarrassment. For me, I think it's just a matter that, hey, look, you know, everyone has sat there and gone, done, wish I'd been brave enough that, you know, go when we could not have fixed before running after, you know, and as a direct result, it's just one that it's so addictive.
Yeah.
I can see kind of live it almost.
Mm. God, I tell you what, either my internet is gone.
No. I was just about to ask Stu, Luke, what you just said, this sounded like it was really interesting, but almost every other word dropped out.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no.
Did you have the same experience there, Stu?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I absolutely did.
Yeah. So, Luke, hang on a second, because it sounds like we're having some technical difficulties.
Yeah, I mean, I think, like, Like every bloody week at the moment, there's a technical issue everywhere. It doesn't matter who we seem to be with, who we go with, what system we use. Right, as long as we can get the audio through, Bob's your answer.
Let's go for it.
I mean, I really think, as Luke was saying, you know, when we went over to Poland and what have you for Fairweather Manor, and what I mean, all right, the that is a proper business doing it, right? So yes, you are going to expect the quality of that LARP to be exponentially more. But I'm saying, like, across the board, from what we've seen coming into LARPBook, and what have you, with people posting images and videos and things to us, that the whole level has just gone up exponentially.
Yep, absolutely has.
Yeah, I think.
I think it's,
well, when
go on.
Well, what think about it? This isn't a new concept. Land's Trust. I mean, as a business, that started off with just a group of friends. You can't being around, you know, the fact that creating an environment, a lot of you and I met good old days, I suppose, when the Lorien Trust could 1,000 people for one event, and huge, and they'd come from all.
Sorry, Luke, mate. You completely, the audio completely went off then right at the end.
Yeah. Look,
and that was really.
Do you want to just try turning it off and back on again?
Honestly, paid IT people. But yeah, I can. Hang on a second.
Right. While he's doing that, then the whole sort of the sheer level of professionalism, the sheer level of writing, the costumes. You know, people are putting much more work into their costumes. Whether they're buying them, whether they're making them, etc. You know, it all just is fantastic. The sheer level has just gone up massively.
It has. I think part of it is the sheer number of emporiums selling really good quality costumes.
Mm.
And the fact that they can source them now as well, it makes a big difference, because now you haven't got to be good at making a costume making to have a good costume. If you can't make it, you can buy it.
Yeah.
If you can make it, you can have something unique and individual, and that's wonderful.
Yeah, exactly.
But, you know, at some of these places, I mean, people like LARPing, Chow's employment in the UK, they're selling to film and theatre production companies now as well.
Yeah, no, exactly. You know, that just shows the sheer level of professionalism that is going on. And Luke, if you're trying to get in or what have you, right, and if you're trying to text me, don't, because I turn my phone off.
If you can just go back to the room's address, Luke, if you can hear us, then just do that and you will, as if by magic, reappear.
As if by magic. And also, let's talk about a little bit about the acceptance then of LARP in this country, where before it was, it was ridiculed by the media. With all the best intentions, in the world, every single one that they did always seemed to me as less poke fun at the nerds. And now that doesn't seem to be the case anymore.
No, that seems to be dissipating. In fact, if our experience as journalists is anything to go by the last month and a half, then they are actually now taking an active interest in this. Might be something everyone's interested in, not let's poke fun at the nerds in funny costumes.
Yeah. Yeah, no, exactly. Which is superb. So Luke's obviously struggling to get back in, yeah?
Yeah, so we will try to materialise Luke shortly.
Have you tried turning it off now and again?
Okay, look, just reverse the flow on the EPS system, you'll be fine.
Yeah.
Just get those manifolds checked, man.
Just wondering if I can hear him or something.
Very carefully, there might be a Luke out there.
Luke, is there anybody there? Oh, dude. Really wanted to come in as well.
Yeah. Oh, come back, Luke.
All is forgiven. There's nothing to forgive. What are you talking about?
Yeah. The dog's eating his rooter.
Tell the kids to get off the PlayStations. Daddy's got to work. Right, so anyway, we'll just carry on regardless.
We'll just wrap it on, yeah.
I think
the thing that I think is helping a lot is that if you go back a couple of years, it was hard to get any photographs of it or videos of it that looked anything but terrible.
Yeah.
But now the quality of the pictures coming out from all over the world, quality of the video coming out, is just so high. Yeah. People are looking at it and going, wow, what is that?
Exactly. That is, you hit it there on the nail on the head, as they say. Some of the, you know, because there are no professional photographers that are going along to these events as well and taking some incredible shots, you know, of people and events and things. And that's awesome as far as, you know, as far as I'm concerned, because it puts it into not only like a better light, but a more, how can I put, not added realism, wrong word, but usually gives over the flavor then of the event as well.
I think that's a good picture. Well, it'll paint like what the event looks like and feels like. You know, a badly done photograph is sort of people too far away, not really in focus, the lighting not done right.
Yeah,
but it's hard to take a good photograph that actually encompasses what's going on. But a good photographer, and we're seeing some great LARP photographers out there now, all over the world, and they're really making it look, I don't know, cinematic or theatrical.
Yeah, yeah. No, exactly. Exactly right. Right, so I kind of wanted Luke to come in on this, but if he can't get in, and Luke, if you can hear us, sorry, but nothing is coming through. You might want to try completely restarting your computer. I don't know.
That might be an answer, actually. I mean, I know it's going to take a while to do, but just because computers don't never start as fast as we want them to.
No. Okay, right. If Luke managed to get in, we'll come back to this.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Okay, audience. Yeah. When Luke gets back, we'll go back.
Yeah.
If not, we'll just move on now for a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. So, 2016 and what have you. Rob and I went today through all the posts and what have you that we've actually put up on LARPBook, and my God, there's much more there than we actually thought we put up.
What all this stuff?
Yeah, I mean, the list keeps going on. You know, things like is character death a good thing? You know, LARPer pride with Claus. That's a little bit about what we were talking about there. You know, as in having a bit of pride now that you are a LARPer. You know, we had things like the UK pirate festivals that are all around the country throughout the year. I mean, it seems as well. There's a massive amounts of them. There were the LARP awards as well. And of course, LARPCon.
Which we're probably going to. The next LARPCon is coming in February. We're planning on being in February or March. Well, we'll be there anyway.
Yeah, that is our plan. I know Rob had a fantastic one on LARP safe walking sticks, and that just seems to be keep on going as people come up with designs or ways of doing things what have you, which that just keeps going.
That came back in that, or as people read it and caught on with the idea, we've had a number of people putting up alt variations of what they thought would be a good design. We've ended up with what we think is a really good one.
Yeah.
The next job, I guess, is to build a couple and put them into action.
Yeah, no, exactly. I'm just going to turn my phone back on a minute, so I'm going to take it out of the thing just in case.
Yeah, he's trying to text anyway.
Yeah, Luke does just try to text, and he hasn't heard saying, don't bother texting. Yeah.
If you can't text, although my mobile isn't in front of me, my office phone is, so call my office.
Yeah, call the office. Shared office, I guess. So that was continuing on. We had loads of people actually add their events and what have you to their game systems profile to the site as well. We had loads of them come in, which is great. You know, if you profile your game system with us, people can find you.
We want to continue that. So I'll put the link in show notes to the LARP profiling page where you can actually tell us what you're about. And send them in, and we'll be really happy to get as many up as we can from as many countries as we can.
Yeah, no, exactly right. Let me just check my email. Sorry about this, folks. Do apologize. Just in case he's emailed me. No. Right, okay. Right, so we've had those. Of course, we had some fantastic interviews this year as well. Dave from the Wilderness Centre, what a fantastic guy he was.
Yeah.
Absolutely wonderful. Awesome. Other interviews, of course, with our main man, Klaus, obviously.
Thank you, Klaus. You've been a real great supporter of LARPBook. Thank you very much.
Yeah, absolutely. Cheyenne and Anthony as well, of course, from LARP House.
They were great fun.
Yeah. What a fantastic duo they make. And they're still producing fantastic videos all the time.
They're never stopping.
No.
I can try on.
Yeah, so that's absolutely superb. And that just brings us up to April so far. I mean, it really has been a fantastically busy year. And it's all helped through you guys that send us stuff. Yeah, it's as simple as that. So what we want you to do is to, keep sending us stuff. Yeah? LARPBookshow@gmail.com. That's LARPBookshow@gmail.com. Yeah? It's at the bottom of this video as well. You can't miss it. Yeah.
Yeah, you send it in and we'll do the best we can with it.
Yeah, absolutely. What else have we got, Rob? We got lots and lots of things.
Well, May saw the release of a LARP writing tool.
Oh, yes, yeah.
That came out of Klaus's and his associate stable, which is Spindle, which looks like a really nice collaborative bit of software.
Okay.
I think now that it's been in production for about 6 months, I might go back and revisit that and see how it's evolved.
Yeah. Let me just text Luke.
Okay.
problems? ? Send. Spindle does look like a very interesting tool. I am going to make an assumption that Klaus and his team use that to actually build their games as well.
Yeah, they do. They were the pre-production testers. Well, yeah. Amongst them, there are a lot of pre-production testers, but they do use it themselves.
Yeah.
And if you look at it, it's got the concepts that they use character creation built into it.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, little things like, you know, what's your character's keywords? You know, what are the keywords that's just instantly sum your character up?
Okay.
We ran into it fair weather, which is, nice simple idea.
Yeah. Absolutely. So that works. I mean, that works very well. We've kind of seen that now in practice. And that does actually work very well. So that's Spindle. If anybody's interested in that, have a look up on LARPBook. I'm sure that you can do a search for Spindle and you'll find the article for that. So let's have a look. Let's scroll down the list a bit more. We had one of the most fantastic posts we ever had was Adam Savage's Tested, a good place for LARPers. Yeah, for LARPers to get ideas and what have you. That thing went bonkers.
Yeah, people like Adam Sandwich.
I can't imagine why. And fair play, that was not only an excellent thing as always that Adam Savage and the Tested crew put out, but it was sort of geared towards LARPers as well, you know, in that respect. But it is a good place if you're looking for ideas for things.
How to make things, how to do things. Just how to make stuff work, it's great.
Yeah, absolutely.
And don't ever send me anywhere near San Francisco because I will raid his man cave.
Oh, yeah. And that sounds a bit dirty as well. But anyway...
That's wrong, Adam, your spacesuits are not safe.
For any of your gadgets and gizmos with me, mate. Especially that spider thing you got. Mm-hmm. So we had loads of events that were listed up on the site as well. Thank you very much for that, everybody that actually sent in when you're having an event. Guess what? We've got a section for that as well. If you're having an event, send it in. It goes out to everybody. Please. Yeah. Just because you happen to be in the USA or Poland or Czechoslovakia or whatever, or somewhere in North Wales, doesn't matter, right? Send it in to us, because you don't know. You have no idea who actually looks at the website, because everybody looks at it from all over the world. Yeah. So
you'll never know when you'll get somebody who's from anywhere who wants to pop in or just have a chat.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, again, LARPBook. No, have we got an actual submission thing for events?
Yeah, we have, yeah. There is an event form. Part of the planned redesign, which I keep chatting about to ages to the patrons, is we're going to alter the menus to make some of this stuff a lot easier to find. Because this year we've been analysing the site to death and found that we've got great content. Well, if we think we've got great content.
Well,
and people are saying we have, so I'm going to believe them.
Yeah, we have.
But sometimes some of the forms can be a bit hard to find. So I think the great planned redesign will be more about making stuff more accessible.
Yeah, yeah. I completely agree with that. So like I said, there is a form up there where you can submit your event, and you know it gets fed into the big LARPBook machine, and then goes out to everybody, and we tell everybody on Facebook, etc., blah, blah, blah. Yeah, so get them over to us, right?
Yeah.
It'll help you out, it'll help us out, it'll help everybody out at the end of the day.
And in case you're wondering how we do it, what we do is we normally put it up on our website, put it up on our Facebook pages and Twitter, but we cross-post to quite a few places as well to make sure it's getting a reasonable audience.
Yeah, exactly. And that's for free. We don't charge for this. We don't charge for any of this, by the way. Yeah? There is no charge. No money changes hands. But if you want to give us some money to help us out, then patreon.com/LARPBook. Just thought I'd get that one in there.
Yeah, you get in there somewhere.
You know. But yeah, you know, we literally do all this for no money at all. Yeah? So it costs you nothing other than a little bit of your time to type the things out. End of story.
Yeah.
What else have we got in there, Rob? We've got we did some things on Kickstarter as well, where we looked at Change Blade. Remember that?
Oh yeah, the Change Blade was really interesting. So
it was,
picked up a lot of it. And it didn't just pick up interest from us, a lot of different people around the world got really behind that. I think in the end the last thing I heard was that the Kickstarter on Change Blade failed. But they were launching it as a smaller scale company regardless.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, even though that failed, right, they're going ahead with it because they can see that there is, you know, a nice dedicated bunch that will want these sorts of things. So, fantastic. That is so superb news. Right, what else we got? And we come back then, of course, to again, children in LARP. There was plenty of updates on that. Throughout the year, after the question was posed by Luke and Becky's wonderful children, Izzy and Charlie. And if you haven't seen that interview, go and have a look at that interview, because it's number one, it's a great interview. They're great kids. But not only that, the questions that were asked are very pertinent, especially as us LARPers are getting a little bit older and having children, etc. So we want to continue LARPing, and we want to take the kids along as well. Yeah, but we want to make sure that they also have a good time while we're in the beer tent. Good parenting. No. Well, naturally, we take them along to the beer tent. Hang on.
That sounds wrong.
They have a great time. It's social interaction.
Yeah, we've had... Really, first of all, I want to thank everybody who's written in about that, because we've had some nice feedback from everyone. We've got an expanding page of UK stuff, shorter page of US, but US is taking a different direction, which is kind of interesting. So if you want to try a different way of doing children's LARP, have a look at the US. And shortly we're going to be releasing some stuff that's going on in Europe as well.
Cool.
And I promise it won't be Denmark, Norway, Norway, Sweden, Denmark. We're not more interested in that.
honest Gov, is he?
Yeah.
Bless. So let's have a look. What else are we just looking down? This list is huge. I mean, let's talk a little bit about Fairweather Manor as well.
We've done a lot of talking about Fairweather Manor this year, but
we did a lot of talking.
Thank you for your patience, but it was important.
Yeah, it was important because it was our first foray into a big production European LARP and looking at LARP as a holiday. So, as you know, as Rob said, thank you very much for your patience, everybody, because there was a lot of information that we put out there, but we felt that it was necessary to put that information out because we wanted to give you as full and complete a picture as possible. So I hope we did that, and I hope it has, you know, informed you. And if you are, you know, going across to a LARP in a European country or what have you, then let us know. Let us know that you've done that, because, you know, it would be very interesting to get your take on it.
Sure. There's some really big LARPs coming up. The big science fiction one coming up in the States next year in California. I'd love to hear what's going on there.
Yeah. Absolutely.
But anywhere. Please.
Yes.
Do I keep seeing anywhere? Probably.
Probably. Yeah, exactly. So it looks like Luke's trying to get back in again. Bless him.
Come on. Yeah, you can do it. Come on. You can do it.
It's just not playing, is it?
Oh, this is awful. But look, if you can't get on this time, please come back for the next one.
Yeah, please come back for the next one, and we'll have a good chat, mate. We'll have a good chat. I'll see if there's another system we can use. Maybe it's this system or what have you. I have no idea.
Yeah, we've used Skype, and I know a lot of podcasts use Skype to varying degrees of success. Oh, hang on, I can see a text message.
Yeah, I got an in here now. Let me just put on there. Computer just went down. I bet it was a bloody Microsoft update.
Your computer is updating.
Oh, he's logging onto the laptop. Good lad. That's the way. See, look, that's dedication for you. That's dedication, folks.
The most awesome dedication is Luke is now putting his laptop into being useful again.
Yeah. You want to know, he probably hasn't used his laptop in like a month ago, like, we're doing some updates. But anyway, yes.
So anyway, yes. Yeah, we will be looking at the technology behind how we bring everybody in and together. This system has been really useful, but every now and again, systems,
good. I'm glad you can hear us, Luke. We can't hear you, unfortunately.
We know we will eventually.
Yeah, but you know, let's try the laptop. But
75% into an update.
Ooh.
You can update.
80%.
80% is coming.
Right. So let's just carry on a little bit, Rob.
Okay.
So let's have a little look then.
Let's try some of the games we've seen this year, because we found
we had a great
time of Curious Chaos Times. I think that's the computer he's talking to now, folks.
Yeah. By the way, everything you're typing there is going on the video, just let you know.
Yeah.
So be careful. Clean tag. Tag. All right.
What, for the man who spells out dirty words in biscuits?
Yeah, in biscuits. by the way.
Yes, folks, he really does that.
Yeah. His long-suffering wife, Becky, bought these alphabet biscuits for the kids. Yeah, for the kids.
Yeah. No, they weren't.
Then the biggest kid in the house got hold of them. I'm just going to leave it at that. So anyway, Rob, yes.
Year before, actually 2015, I started to get introduced to people like New Thea and Wyvern's Tales. And we did a couple of those games this year. And I'm going back again in 2017 to do some crewing.
Okay.
You know, from our own systems, that's growing up again. We had a great time at Curious Pastimes.
Yeah, okay.
planning on going back there again now next year.
Yeah.
But what else have we seen? But I've also seen some other games coming up which I really think we should take a look at. I mean, things like Orc Larp looks hilarious.
Yeah, agreed.
And I'm really loving the look of some of the post-apocalyptic stuff. People like places like Old Town Wood went dark. Oh, I really want to give it a go.
Yes, I would like to do an apocalyptic LARP. Mainly because I can't say it properly.
No. Or things like Gulag, which would be LARP where you have to try to survival is.
No, because look.
There's no comfort in that game, is there?
No. Yeah. Right, I think I'd much rather do a post-apocalyptic one in a desert where at least it'll be warm. Yeah. The Gulag
If you're wondering what you're talking about, is Gulag is a game that's set in Georgia, for which they're representing the British countryside, which is probably even damper, more unpleasant than Georgia anyway.
Yeah.
Except not as cold, but certainly damper.
Yeah, too right. So
It's the game where players literally have no real home comforts and have to survive in very basic camps for a few days.
Yeah. In fact, I reckon we should have a look at to see whether or not there are any LARPs in places like Goa or something. What do you reckon?
Oh, Goa LARP. Yeah. Although I'm really fancying actually what they're doing in Jamaica as well.
Yeah, but then again, of course, you know, let's be honest, right? Klaus has had the right idea, right? They've just done a whole spate in Poland where it was really cold, yeah?
And now they're going to
Abu Dhabi, right? So he's had his bones chilled. Now he's getting them warmed back up again.
Clever planning.
Yeah, and I tell you what, the what they're doing out there as well looks pretty awesome.
It does.
They're doing it. It's a how can I put it? It's like, think of a Disney ride. Yeah, is the best way to describe it. Yeah, think of a Disney ride that you participate in,
and you actively play in. You're not.
Yeah.
In Pirates of the Caribbean, you sit on a little thing and it chugs you through some really dramatic scenery.
Yeah,
that's kind of nice. Actually, I quite like Pirates of the Caribbean. It's a favorite.
Yeah,
but his. No, you're playing.
Yeah,
you're really are interacting with everything. Ooh, yeah.
No, the Luke's connection kicked out.
Again.
With this one, it's you know, you get dressed up, you pick up a sword, you know, you go off and do some adventures and what have you, all guided then by Klaus and the crew, a lot by looking at the video that we actually met at Fairweather Manor. playing the games and what have you, and they are awesome. We will have links in the show notes for the videos and a post that was done by Klaus about it, and the actual company that's putting this all on. Now we're hoping as well. I'm going to be trying to get hold of Klaus very soon because he did say give him a bell. And we'll do it. We'll do an interview. Now that might be in the daytime, and I'll have to put it up as a separate. It won't be part of the show. Yeah,
but we will try and get that up there. Yeah,
Because I really want to ask him about how this has gone, how it's been received over there as well. And you know, from the videos that we've seen, it looks to be that it's been received very well, and a lot of very positive feedback.
And in fact, that's one thing I'd like to ask everybody is that this year we started putting up more small videos. A lot more. Oh, hang on. We have an arrival.
Oh,
there he is.
Hang on just one moment here. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
We can hear you.
Marvellous.
I didn't do the joke.
You were.
I didn't
go. You should have done the joke.
Too late.
Do you know what? Right, everything just went wrong then, and I have no idea what happened at all. I logged off, and it was the worst thing I could have done. My computer just did the equivalent of, and I can't even get it to log on now. So I actually have no idea what happened at all there. Yeah. Only that, you know, kind of if you could just see my face for it, kind of like it was almost like a gibbon looking at people, you know, kind of like something going.
This is honestly right. It's the biggest problem. It's the biggest problem that I am finding at the moment with Windows 10. Yeah, is the sheer fact that the operating system just decides where and when. If you haven't set things up in the updates and recovery of do not do anything between these times and all the rest of it, right? Then guess what? When you're in the middle of a really important spreadsheet that you haven't saved properly, your machine goes, I'll do some updates now. I'm just restarting.
I say every time I do it, I turn it off and it goes, oh yeah, there are updates. We could be here for a while.
Wow.
And it's just, you know, you sit there and go, oh, but every time I think of it, I think of you, me and Alistair talking about Windows and how frustrated we all get. And I live for the days now of Linux again. I really do. But there we go. So what have I missed?
Oh, there was Rob.
Rob, obviously. Rob, this guy's just me and you now. Are we tag teaming this? What the hell is going on? So what, is Rob computer's gone? Hang on a minute. Is Luke all right now? Is he on? Right, I can go now. So I'll just, you know. It's just, so Stuart is the only constant here at the moment.
Oh my God.
By hook or by crook, we're going to bloody well do this New Year kind of thing. We're going to look at the whole bloody year and no one's going home until it's all done. No matter what you do and what happens to your login, everyone's going to do this.
Oh my God. Oh, seriously.
Oh. God, did you? I'm so sorry because I hadn't realised that the chat as well was actually going out to everyone. So I was going 80%. Come on, you twats! Come on! And it is so for honestly, but it you is, know what is. I was going through. So I'm on my laptop now.
It is very frustrating. So anyway, we're going to go a little back up to the top.
Well, let's just wing it like we used to do.
Yeah.
Why do we bother? Technology's just kicking us right in the ghoulies, isn't it?
Yeah,
I mean,
time.
We're practically stood with our legs open. That's what it is, isn't it? And fate is just walloping us in the ghoulies every single time. It's just bloody well embarrassing.
Pretty much. And
I bet you've had it. I bet you've had it good since I haven't been on as well, haven't you? No technical hitches. No fat boy turns up and everything goes wrong.
No, for the last four podcasts, right?
Yeah.
There has been something, either the audio wasn't recorded, this system screwed up, we couldn't get onto something, the video's gone, Rob's internet was going up and down like a bloody nun's knickers. You know what I mean? Right, honest to God.
We even lost an entire podcast and we had to go back and record it. Ended up in a different podcast.
How did you lose an entire podcast?
We lost an entire podcast because only my voice was being recorded. So it's all like, oh, yeah. And it's for everybody else.
That's almost like kind of personal stereo greatest hits, isn't it?
Yeah.
In one side of a really shit conversation. That's right. Yeah.
Exactly.
Wow. So hasn't the year gone well? Let's get it all in now before something else goes wrong.
Yeah.
I've had a great time, haven't we? LARP's fantastic. There's nothing wrong with it at all.
That's awesome.
Oh, it's marvellous, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's wonderful. Yeah. Stewie's got a new background. Yeah. So Karen's obviously hasn't seen the bill yet.
No.
mate, it's all green screen. There's just shit behind you, mate.
It's just like mine. Can you see here? I think I've gained a high vis.
The high vis collection.
I've gained a high vis. That's it.
Are you breeding them, Luke?
Am I breeding them? No, I think they've just been there so long now, they're breeding themselves.
No.
They've got little baby ones there and everything. They get really miffed when I come in. It's just... And you can see right here, look, being the typical conscious person I am about fire, I've turned it off. And it's like...
That's exactly what I was going to say. The health and safety trainer has ripped the battery.
I'm sick of it going off. So what was the most sensible thing to do? Put the battery out like everyone else. Hey, look, I said I was a health and safety consultant. I didn't say I was any good, did I? Hey? God, I hope none of my clients are seeing this.
No.
Just imagine the conversation, can't you? And now I'd like you to refer you to an interview that you had with two of your friends. Let's just see what you said there, shall we, about fire safety.
as he just quietly nudges the lap.
That's right, yeah, you're just kind of like...
Oh god. Oh, I've missed this.
So, right. What have I missed?
Right. Anyway, we were talking about some of the things that have been on the LARPBook website
over the last year.
I'd have probably been bored anyway, so I'm glad I missed that kind of great.
Basically, you cut out where we're chatting about what's been going well with LARP, because we couldn't really hear a word you were saying.
So we'll go back to that, I think. Yeah.
Okay.
We think you had some good stuff going on there. Bring that back. Go back. Knock it back.
Yeah.
We'll just re-enter the idea.
Yeah. So, I feel that LARP has been put more in a positive light in 2016 by the media and everybody else. You know, it's gone. It seems to have moved away from the let's point at the nerds. Yeah, to actually, this is a great pastime and an educational tool and a this and a that and what have you. And they do seem to be coming away from the whole thing that Klaus used to really hate about the British media. And I don't know if we should say this, but I won't say who it was for. Yeah. But while we were over in Poland, we were actually interviewed by a film crew that were over there. We can't say who it is yet and what have you until they've actually aired the program. But when they do, they have promised us that we can use that footage as well, which is only right, because we're bloody on it, etc. So you know, and the questions that they did ask didn't sound or feel condescending.
I would say they didn't feel condescending, but they felt inquiring.
Yeah.
As if they were trying to actually understand not just what LARP is, but what it's physically and emotionally it does to play it. Because I was going to put this out, that a film crew from a established TV show put one of their presenters into the game to play.
Yeah.
And right, okay.
Practice progress. And I had conversations with him off book, and we had a very good interview and conversation on camera as well. And what he was couldn't believe was a couple of things. One was the quality of the acting coming from the LARPers.
Yeah.
And that it really helped him immerse and feel like he was in the middle of something. He really wasn't expecting LARPers to be able to play characters. And the other thing that got to him was just how emotionally and physically draining it was. He wasn't expecting to be actually feeling sort of emotionally involved and tired and all the other things he was feeling.
Well, haven't we always said that, you know, kind of the one thing, the great thing about LARPing, if you can get a good group together, is the ability for the whole group to make you believe you're where you know, where the scenario needs you to be. Yeah. And I always remember, you guys will probably remember this, at Barnswood, do you remember we were doing the final battle one year and then the scouts turned up and the looks that we were getting off them were incredible. Yeah. And I think it epitomised exactly what Klaus said, that he felt that we were just overly conservative, we were very, very negative. And I think now that that same scout group, if they were to see us doing that again, would probably be entertaining the thought and go, actually, do you know what, that looks like a lot of fun. And it isn't about, you know, because you can, like you say, you can do the emotionally, you know, kind of kind of role play. And I think there's a part for that. We've always said that you can do what you want. You can be the comic if you really want to be. You can be the mass murderer. You can be whatever you want to be. Role play allows you to do it. But I think we're away from that, which is why I said 10 years before. I think that really we can actually, you know, kind of appeal to a far broader, you know, audience, but we're taking leaps every single year. It seems to be more socially acceptable. I think people are more prepared to sit there and go, do you know what, I'll have a look at that and just attend specific things, whether it be the pirate LARP that, you know, I've been experimenting with. And, you know, and it is, and it's so much better. You're finding people are so much more open-minded. And I think that's because they are looking for something to immerse themselves into. And LARP has always had that door open. It's just we've chosen never to go through it. And I see that now is something that is becoming, you know, when we saw the video, didn't we, that came out, the DVD that we were pushing last year.
They were so very open for it.
And it's not a bad thing. And, you know, like I say, geek is good. It's becoming more popular. I think people are suddenly realise they've got the inner geek. What they thought was their inner pigeon is actually an inner geek. We all wear glasses, do this quite a lot, and, you know, kind of suffer with asthma, which is, you know, kind of everything that we think geeks do. And I think, it, as I've shown you on Facebook, there are an awful lot of people now who are taking it so much more seriously. And it's growing. And you look at Gideon Lawrence. Gideon Lawrence was, as you know, Rob and I will... really kind of attest to was the fact that he was so immersed into it. It is his life, and it has become now a job for him. And I think that people like him, the talent like him, because he does storytelling, doesn't he?
Storyteller.
I mean, and isn't that just an offshoot to such a wonderful thing? He's got such a good imagination that he can now inspire kids to want to have an imagination, hopefully start, you know, from an educational point of view, start to have a look at reading and going back to Tolkien and Terry Pratchett and, you know, all the greats. And I see that as a very, very positive thing. And I think that 2016 has been a kind of like a springboard, if you will, to enlightenment. I think it's been a huge light bulb moment for many people who are now starting to see it as we have always said it should be seen, in that kind of light, that it's not a weird fetish. It's so much more, you know, kind of obviously there is that element of it still there, isn't there? But it's so broad that I think just to kind of stereotype it and label it as a kind of like an S&M kind of thing just doesn't give it any kind of credibility or does it any kind of justice.
Because it's not. I mean, it's the one thing. It's the one thing that a lot of places are now trying to introduce, and this is across the board. That's fine. In different industries, right? Is this whole thing about play? Play is good. Play is healthy. It's healthy for the psyche. You know,
and you've seen my kids. Like,
everything, yeah.
I mean, my kids are just the biggest role players ever.
Yeah.
And, you know, and actually the only thing I have found with especially with Izzy, is that she's so confident that people find it quite threatening. You know, because she's out there and, you know, and of course she can't stop talking about the film that we've been in that we helped Lou Ferrigno out with. This hasn't been bloody released yet, by the way.
Apparently next year I was talking to Diamond.
Was he? Oh, right, that's brilliant, because I've got 70 copies on order now to bump up the release on it, you know. I've already put it forward for an Oscar, but I'm not actually sure why. But, it, you know, it should be best director, best supporting role as well, best, I think, should be to us.
You know, best supporting actors. Yeah,
that's right, yeah. But you're seeing that, and I think, Charlie, the one thing he absolutely loves is the combat, and as a young lad he sees that, you know, kind of, and we've definitely supported that. For Izzy, it was started off as being the little princess, and now she wants to learn magic, and there's some beautiful photographs that we've got throughout the years. I mean, bear in mind they've done it literally from year one. And you know, and actually how the LARP groups, you know, kind of entertain the concept as well of having children, and they've adapted to all of that. It's just stuff that we've talked about. And I think that that is going to, you know, get that kind of publicity that I think LARP really truly needed. And hopefully if this show progresses as well, that, you know, that you're going to see a lot more people giving it a whirl, listening to what we've got to say, and then going, do you know what, actually, that they've been right all along. They have been right all along.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, if we go back to the pirate stuff, for instance, those pirate events throughout the UK, throughout the year, right?
Yeah, yeah.
They are an amazing introduction, because, number one, they are public. And that's a big move, which means anybody can go along and
wander along, go right in the middle of it, almost anything apart from a planned combat.
A planned combat, that's right, yeah. You know, and be introduced to the concept, you know, and you can see people's like little light bulb moment going off, you know, as in like, do you know what? It's actually a good laugh, you know.
Actually, we've had a couple of drinks. This is really good.
Yeah.
You're the good one for you. You both know my missus, yeah?
Yeah.
And you both know she's not really much of a LARPing fan at all. In fact, she refuses to go anywhere near them.
Yeah, because she thinks we're all geeks and nerds.
Well, actually, she thinks we can lock her in the kitchen because she cooks really well.
I want to add at this point, I've nearly seen your wife naked.
Yeah.
Yes, you have.
Yeah.
Me too.
That was awkward.
Yeah.
Well,
especially as I was looking for a towel at the time. I shouldn't have whipped it off. I shouldn't have whipped it off.
That sounds dangerous.
Maybe that was where I went wrong.
Yeah. And then that, you might have got away with it. Yeah. But also, when she went to the pirate LARP and she saw the quality of the pirate costumes, the pirate cosplayers play, the quality of the guys dressing up in steampunk costumes, up the way up, because she hadn't even seen that before. And then when she saw the pirate playing with her grandson, and how well he was responding, she went, you know what? Maybe I have been a bit harsh on this over the years.
Well, yeah, and it's a win, isn't it? I mean, thankfully, when I first met Becky, she was nuts enough to entertain the idea. And I said, you got to come to these events. They're so much fun. And literally, I ensnared her there and then. That's when I knew she was a woman for me. And, you know, and I think you're lucky because I think an awful lot of couples do have that one person who simply can't see it. And then the other person who is just immersed. You know, and for many years, that was Alistair and Amy, wasn't it? Amy was kind of going along, you know, with it. And I think still she kind of teeters on the edge of it, whereas Alistair is just completely, you know, he's married to it almost, isn't he? I think it's a shared marriage.
Yeah. It happens a bit, actually. Some couples are just both totally immersed. Some just wonder. Mm. But that's okay, because as long as that dynamic works out well between them.
Yeah, absolutely.
No issues.
But what I was getting to is I'm seeing an awful lot of couples, like you were saying now, warm into the idea. So, you know, one of the people might go just and they might wear a cloak and just, you know, absorb it and just go and wander around aimlessly and they get that out of it. Other people, they've got to be part of it. They've got to be right in the middle of all the trouble. That's me and you, Stu. We're actually just sitting on the sideline is something we simply cannot do. We just can't. It's like Tourette's. Yeah. You know, you shouldn't say what you are about to say. You know it's going to cause trouble. Yeah. There's a part of you that's going to say it anyway, but before you've even kind of finished that thought process, you've already said it. And I think that has caused more fun, and because people remember that, and I think people on the fringe of it, you know, kind of through years and years and years just doing it, have either learned to stay away from us or have learned to really love LARP because of what it is. And I think that's why I was really interested in, you know, looking at your videos with how you reacted with Claus, because it was such an interesting concept, and he was obviously really generous letting you go in there, because he didn't really know you from, you know, kind of Adam before you met him, and yet he was very welcoming, you know, when he sat there and said, come over, just get over here, we'll do the rest, you know. And you don't get that over here. And I think if we just did that would be the final barrier to break down, wouldn't it?
The entire crew was like that. I mean literally the entire crew was
Yeah, all of his crew are absolutely. I mean, I can't say enough good about them. His whole crew were fantastic.
You know, and of course the other players that we met as well. You know, first of all, the you could see them going like, "Who are these guys?" Because you know, we've got cameras and we've got rigs and steady cam stuff and what have you, and we're trying to go around and do things. We didn't really get to do any interviews, but that was only because that game was full on from word go to the end.
It would have been wrong to break somebody out of being in game for even 5-10 minutes.
Yeah.
That would have really hurt the game for them.
Yeah. I think that's a great thing. I mean, I looked at all the comments. It's got some wonderful photographs. I mean, what a beautiful place as to go to. It looked immense. And I think, again, it's those kind of baby steps. What we need to be really, like, saying, especially for 2016, is this has been the start, again, of this springboard of enlightenment, I think. And, you know, I can't stress enough that, you know, if you as a parent are at all worried, the old stereotype within LARPing, forget it. You just go and see for yourself. Yeah. Because the group's screaming out for really good players, really talented, you know, kind of people who with a little bit of vision and a lot of, you know, kind of imagination, and kids will have such a good time. And we need that new blood coming through. I mean, you know, kind of I'm really feeling it every time I go into a battle now at the age of 44. I'm sat there going, I really need to rest now, because, you know, Alex is kicking my ass again.
It's amazing, Luke, how many more times you want to play a wizard.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Lightning bolt, run away. No, I've decided from now on, it's going to be LARP from a bath chair.
Armchair LARP, isn't it? It's where you're Skyping and then you just sit there and cast and then go for coffee and think it through again. I think it's the way forward, isn't it? Where all of a sudden someone will pop up and you'll have TV screens kind of following you around a little bit.
Why on earth?
Smoking with all the coffee and what have you, you know?
Why on earth, you know, hadn't you realised my last couple of characters, certainly at Kez's events, right, happened to be old geezers that really like tea and chocolate?
Yeah. Yeah, why wouldn't you? I think that's a great thing. I mean, you know, kind of there's so many really good people out there. And I think this is what I've really been, you know, an advocate of. It's just we've got it. I'd love to do more. I really would. I think if my work and my education wasn't really getting in the way of what I was doing, I'd be out there every weekend if I really could be. Yeah. I'd probably be single, but I'd be out there every weekend, you know.
Yeah. Let's be honest. Becky and the kids will be with you, mate. It's as simple as that. If that was the case,
the only thing. It's a lot harder than people give you credit for to get an entire family prepared and ready, and the costing, you know, can get a little bit expensive. But you know, we do have a good time, and they're memories, and that's the great thing is that you look at our Facebook profiles, and all the memories, you know, of August events or of us doing stupid things. And one of the ones that really sticks in my mind is when we had to bring Odin, my Rottie, and we got a photograph of Izzy on a kind of like an overhanging bar, and then the dog right at the bottom. You can just see him kind of coming up, going for a shoes because he was trying to get a shoes, and you know, those kind of things, and her casting a spell and what have you, and the photograph that Becky did of her casting light. She was actually casting a spell at the time, and then we photoshopped all of that in. You can't buy it, and I think that people have really got to understand that from a point of view, you know, I feel as if my life has been very enriched by you know, kind of LARPing, and I've met some great crazy ass people. Look at you two. I've met some crazy people, and you know, and I wouldn't have it any other way. That's the thing. I think that's what makes LARPing so special, is that you meet a whole bunch of crazy people.
And you can ask my daughter, she will happily tell you that doing all the LARPing and what have you that she did, certainly with me as she was growing up and what have you, put her into such a big social circle that she has no trouble at all talking to anybody about anything, you know. She can stand up in front of a crowd of 500, you know, she can talk to someone in, you know, on one-to-one, whatever age group, whatever background, because it's given her that wide experience, you know, to be able to do that.
Yeah.
And that's the great thing about it. I mean, like I say, kids or not, I mean, even if you were, you know, kind of single, not that this is, it's kind of like a dating site, but I'm absolutely convinced that half of the couples I know have met through LARPing. You know, so, and like I said, I don't want to emphasize that. I just think that, you know, kind of like-minded people, isn't it? But I love it. And I think it's a whole community. I think I really marvel at the dedication that people have, that we, week in, week out, like I always notice Gideon as well, coming back to him, he's always doing something, he's always running an event, and he goes between, you know, kind of steampunk to D&D to the, you know, kind of the Japanese scenario that we kind of went to as well, to lots of different things. And I think that this is why it is so good, because you just have to sit there and go, what do I like? There's always someone somewhere doing something you like. And I think that from that point of view, what a great year. And we've seen lots of different things happen. It is, I think for a lot of people, it's been quite, you know, kind of a busy year, because lots have happened in all industries, and all things have, lots have been going on. But I think LARPing is now this escape that people are now coming to.
Well, look, I mean, it's born out of the invention as well of these adventure rooms that are popping up all over the place. I mean, if that's not a LARP, I don't know what is.
It's a mini LARP.
It's like an hour.
Limited LARP.
It's like a 2 hour LARP, but it's still a LARP, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Are popping up everywhere.
We're going back. I'm trying to get it organised in the late 80s. It might as well be the 1680s, considering how old I feel I am. 16. I actually went to Orpington, which were the one of the very first, you know, major LARPing venues. And we're going back to the caves, and myself and hopefully Carl Homer and a few other people that actually went on that initial kind of thing. And that was our very first LARP. We're going back and we're going to do it again. Cool. And I think this is the great thing, that this has been, what, you know, 20, 30 years now, you know, and we're going back now just to, you know, kind of have an almost like a reunion and get the shit kicked out of us again, which is wonderful. It's such a great thing. And actually, strange, it's such a small world as well, that people I was meeting at the Kettering, the one of the guys there actually knows all the, you know, kind of people who run venue. And so he said, oh yeah, when you're ready, just, you know, kind of let us know, we'll fit you in.
Excellent.
So it's great. I feel as if, you know, kind of I want to relive those years again. Talk about midlife crisis, Christ, I don't know. I'll be getting a new haircut and everything.
So your midlife crisis is not a motorcycle then. It's buying some new LARP gear to do an old LARP that you did.
Yeah, basically. Yeah. I'm going to make my old kind of, you know, tape weapons and just go back, you know.
Boffer
LARP, isn't it? But it is, and I think that some of the best times I've ever had, and the people I've met have been in LARP. So, you know, I don't think I'd ever want to change that, you know, kind of. And I think, Lee, you look at all our friends as well. I mean, look how well Jamie's doing now with you know, kind of LARPing. And that's just a classic example, isn't it, of the desire to want to do something that you genuinely love. And here he is now, a big supplier. He's now doing relatively well. You can't take that away from him. And that's great, because I should imagine now, I mean, he lives, doesn't he, for, you know, kind of the gathering, the Lorien Trust. He actually goes and lives there, doesn't he, for a few months whilst they're doing their, you know, kind of moots. And that's great. It's absolutely brilliant. So to see that kind of transformation, I mean, I remember Jamie when he was this high and we were, you know, cheating marvellously at D&D like everyone else was, you know, so it's a great thing, and you know, kind of they're lifelong friends, and you know, kind of people that, you know, and it is great. Are you going back to Poland? Are you going to do that again, or is this?
It's not on the cards for me in the future at the moment. But I think what we want to do now is have a look about what else is available around the world.
You were talking about the Seychelles, weren't you, Stuart? Somewhere warmer,
or even Abu Dhabi is fine.
I think I'd like to go back now to another of these high production value Blockbuster in Europe. I mean, I really was impressed when I took to Poland. Poland's lovely.
Yeah. But loads of people said that get cold.
Cold, yeah. Bloody cold. I fancy doing a post apocalyptic LARP.
Yeah.
I fancy doing something like, you know, Mad Maxy style, whatever type thing, right? You know.
Do you know Germany is where I'd like to? I think because they've embraced it big time, haven't they?
Conquest and Drakenquest is so big.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, they do huge fairs, don't they, as well, of, you know, where people are kind of semi-cosplaying. And I'd love to, because I've seen, throughout the years, I've seen about four or five different traders that have been invited over to events, strange events that I never thought had that kind of, you know, relation. Yeah. And actually, all of that has just been, you know, kind of really, really good. And I'd love to go over there because they've got some amazing kit, some awesome mead as well. Mead. It's the way forward.
It's what powers LARPs.
Yes.
You know, it is what powers LARPs. The interestingly, I just want to skip back a minute or two. Were you saying about the acceptance of LARP and what have you?
Yeah.
The biggest person that I thought ever got won over by the acceptance of LARP was my own father.
Right. Yeah,
you know, you remember that he was always, you know, always, my dad always loved to quote the thing, when I was a boy I played with childish things, and now I'm a man, whatever that saying is, etc., blah blah blah, right? And I said, look, come along, have a look, we'll sneak you in. Sorry, Lorien Trust, we'll sneak you in. Right.
There's a bill coming your way now.
Yeah,
fine. You know the Lorien Trust Inquisition on the way, don't you?
That's right. Yeah. Nobody expects the Lorien Trust Inquisition. and he came along. With, you know, obviously with Mum as well. We stuck him in, and we got them dressed up. Otherwise, they'd have stuck out like a sore thumb. And they wandered around and they had a look at things. They went around the traders and had some food, etc., blah blah blah. And then Dad said to me, "Yeah, all right, I get it now."
I was there, and I do remember the face he gave when you asked him to put a cloak on for the very first time. He said, "Dad, you'll have to wear a cloak."
Yeah, and you know,
he put it on, it was almost like,
"Bye." What are you doing?
And it's kind of complete, he felt really, really uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And he couldn't have stuck out any further. He might as well have been wearing a huge jester costume the way he stuck out, because he walked differently for a while as well, as almost as if, you know, kind of wearing a robe came with its own walk. After kind of like half an hour, you're absolutely right. I mean, he'd seen it for what it really was. And I think he'd seen what we see as well, but you kind of have to be there. Yeah. And this is why I don't get too angry, but it just frustrates me, I think is the proper word, when people, you know, comment on LARP having never ever been to an event. You know, I'm cool with people who go to events and go, do you know what, it's not for me, I don't like it, I can't see it, but go to an event first of all, don't just write it off, you know. There's so much to it,
you know. It's like people saying that they don't like a particular food but they've never tried it.
They have never tried it. You can't do that.
If you don't like it, exactly, that's fine. Everyone's cool with that.
And Christmas is coming, so I get sprouts.
Oh no, that's toxic. We should never give Edward sprouts. There's no good reason for that.
I only get sprouts at Christmas because my wife hates them.
Well, for the rest of smell it. That's why.
Yeah. We all hate you having sprouts, but we're wise enough to stay away for a few days.
Oh yeah,
we're actually going to ban them for the New Year gig, by the way, because there's absolutely no way the house can cope with it. Smell, not with that many people there.
That many people and your dog, no.
Well, actually, he's pretty bad at the best of time because he eats cat food, and that's just a bad mix. Rottweiler and cat food don't mix. If you have a Rottweiler, you know exactly what it is I'm talking about. Just to say, we've bought four packs of those biscuits, those kind of... because there's a genuine need, isn't there, to kind of leave them to see what happens. And that takes me right back to Spike Winter. Do you remember that? How we changed Spike Winter around. And we changed it to something really rude. I forgot what we changed it to now. But it wasn't complimentary at all. And then it was so ace the way it happened. Everyone went, we've got to change that sign back. We've got to change. Don't let us leave without changing that sign. And then Kez went, did you change the sign? And we'd all gone. And he had to go back and change it properly back to Spike Winter again, because we'd all forgotten, convinced ourselves that we needed to do it, and then didn't do it at all. It was just amazing. So we're going to do that again.
I mean, every day that we sort of woke up, somebody had changed it. It was like watching another episode of Fawlty Towers. You know what I mean?
It was brilliant. And then the dancing that Dave, the rest is history. On video as well.
And on video.
For the right money.
Yeah, for a small fee. But excellent. It has been a good year. It has, for LARP anyway. It's been an absolutely shit year if you're a celebrity.
They're all dying, aren't they? It's just horrible.
See, I think it's actually a plot, right? They're actually all not dying. They're all actually going back up to the mothership because we're about to be invaded. Yeah. So that's what's actually happening, you know, because
that's why our internet's going down.
Yeah.
It's all true. Yeah. It's all on Independence Day. We're missing the point here.
Yeah. 9/11 was an inside job.
Down, it's a countdown. You know. End of the world.
Absolutely. But
we'll all have another zombie and an apocalypse. Acropolis. Yeah. I don't know.
Exactly. Yeah, sounds good to me. I'm just having a little look now if there's anything else.
Okay.
Events. So it's time to talk about these sorts of things. If you've got an event that's coming up in 2017, 2018, the year 2020, we don't care. All right. You can, if you can't use the form for whatever reason or you can't find it, just email what it is you're doing to larpbookshow@gmail.com.
You'll put it on the website.
larpbookshow@gmail.com. It's on the bottom of the screen somewhere, but there as well. All right. So. send us stuff. We're here for you. It doesn't cost you anything. We don't charge a red cent for it. So get things advertised. Luke, it's been absolutely fabulous having you here. Go on.
I was going to say, can I book you in for New Year to have a look at my computer? It's now an appropriate time to talk about that.
Probably.
Yeah, the I really do hope that we try and do some more of these, Luke, throughout the year as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. You know, kind of work committing, absolutely. Yeah, I'd love to. It is all great. Fantastic. So, yeah, absolutely. Fantastic. Absolutely marvellous. Thank you for having me.
No problem at all. So, a massive thank you to all our lovely patrons as well, who make it a bit easier to keep this show going. All right, because you help pay for the hosting of the podcast, etc. Right, this all really helps us out. Otherwise, I got to chuck my hand in my wallet, and Luke will tell you that doesn't happen very often.
Well, I've never seen it. I've known it for 20 years now. Never seen it.
And thank you very much as well. We've had some iTunes reviews as well. And I do love some of these names. One Direction But Not is one of them. Gives a lovely 5 stars. And he said, laughed my socks off. So thank you very much for that. And Nexus 7056. I'm sure that must mean something to somebody. Again, 5 stars. And he says, blooming British. Very informative. Very funny. I mean... That's exactly what we were going for. Blooming British, very informative and very funny.
It's what we do.
It's what we do. You know, so thank you very much for those guys. So don't forget, leave us a 5-star review if you actually feel it warrants a 5-star review on iTunes or whatever it is that you use to listen to this podcast. Yeah. Because it does help us out in the long run. More people find us, etc. It all helps out. So, and that's the other thing I'm going to ask. If you like this show, tell somebody else about it because they might like this show as well, you know, and they might tell somebody else and they might tell somebody else and this is how it all works. Yeah. You can pop across to the Facebook thing, you know, larpbook.com, lots. I mean, like I said, we when Luke was having all of his wonderful problems, we were going through all the stuff that we've actually submitted this year, and the list just keeps going. We hadn't realised how much we've actually put up on larpbook.com this year, and it's a huge amount. So we will keep continuing to do that, but you can help us out. If you find something, let us know.
Simple. Yeah, and we'll try to increase it as well. Each year we hope to do more. And so 2017, we won't be ducking so many low-flying, dying celebrities, but hopefully we'll get more in.
Before they die.
Yeah, exactly. So that is superb. So like I say, if you'd like to get in contact with the show, just email larpbookshow@gmail.com. Is there a topic you'd like us to discuss or something cool you saw, or just fancy writing an article for the website, then email the show, larpbookshow@gmail.com. Music was provided by Ben Sound at bensound.com. Don't forget, as I said, we have got a Patreon, okay? It does help us out. Just, you know, give us a dollar a month. I mean, you cannot get a coffee for that. It's as simple as that, right? But it does help us out, yeah? I know. Certainly you can't get a coffee for that in bloody South Wales. I can tell that for a fact. Number one is they don't take dollars.
They don't like it.
No. And, of course, we do have a shop as well over at redbubble.com. Just search for LARPBook. And there's always deals and what have you going on there. I try to post them up as and when I get them also and try to remember, you know, working two jobs, all that sort of stuff. So help us out. So I think that pretty much is us done, guys, to be honest with you. So again, Luke, thank you very, very much for coming along to the show and all the wonderful problems that we had anyway, you know.
It just took me right back. It was marvellous. I've only got to buy a new computer, so it's not that expensive.
No, exactly. Rob, thanks again for being there. This is probably, I don't think there'll be another show before the end of the year, but there might be one. We haven't said yes or no, but it's kind of no at the moment. But we might get bored over Christmas. All right. So you can listen to the podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, YouTube, Podbean. Just search for LARPBook. You will find us. Again, email the show, larpbookshow@gmail.com. The website is larpbook.com. You can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Google+. Just search for LARPBook. That's all you've got to do. And don't forget to give us that wonderful 5-star review on whatever you use to listen to the thing. So this has been me, Stuart. That's been Luke. That's been Rob. Bye-bye.